ॐ नमो भगवते परमहंसरसासादित चरणकमलचिन्मकरन्दाय भक्तजनमानसनिवासाय श्रीरामचन्द्राय नमो नमः। ॐ नमो भगवते परमहंसरसासादित चरणकमलचिन्मकरन्दाय भक्तजनमानसनिवासाय श्रीरामचन्द्राय नमो नमः। आपदम् अपहर्तारं दातारं सर्वसम्पदं रामाभिरामं भूयो भूयो नमामि अहम्। गौड़ीय गोष्ठी पोथी श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड दैट भक्ति इज अ नेचुरल फंक्शन ऑफ योर सोल। भक्ति इज अ नेचुरल फंक्शन ऑफ योर सोल। एक्चुअली द श्लोक आई स्टार्टेड विद इज रिटन बाय श्री शिल सीधा समीपाद द ग्रेट कमेंटर of Srimad Bhagavatam. Now question is that why he is going to glorify Sri Ramchandra whereas he is going to write commentary on Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam no other than Krishna. Sukadeva Goswami is speaking to Parikshit Maharaj. Hey Rajan, this Bhagavatam Srimad Bhagavatam Mahapuran, Krishna Evahi. Now question is that why he is going to glorify Sri Ramchandra? That is the main question. Om Namo Bhagavate Paramahansa Rasasadito Charana Kamala Chinmakarandayo Bhakta Janamana Sanivasayo Sri Ram Chandra Namo Namah. Why is Siddha Samipad going to glorify Sri Ram Chandra? That is the main question. Actually, Siddha Samipad thinking Srimad Bhagavad Mahapuran is the ocean of rasa, transcendental rasa, endless ocean of transcendental rasa. How I can cross over this ocean? It is next to impossible, not possible for me. That's why suddenly he remember that if I take shelter of Sri Ramchandra, then he can make a nice bridge for me. And with the help of that bridge, I can cross over this ocean very easily. Om Namo Bhagavate Paramahansa Rasasadito चरण कमल चिन्ह करंदायो भक्त जन मानस निवासायो श्री राम चंद्रायो नमो नमः। दैट इज व्हाई श्रील सिद्ध साईपाद गोइंग टू ग्लोरीफाई द नेम ऑफ श्री रामचंद्र टेकिंग शेल्टर ऑन टू लोटस फीट ऑफ रामचंद्र टू गेट द हेल्प टू क्रॉस ओवर दिस इन्फिनिटी ओशन ऑफ रस सागर श्रीमद भागवत जी महाप्राण। Now you can remember, I am going to discuss about Maryada Purushottama Sri Ramchandra, his Leela and teachings. See, Maryada Purushottama Sri Ramchandra, his Leela and teachings. You can remember one slok from Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, third canto. Kapil Bhagavan, Kapilya Maharaj speaking in front of Mother Devahuti. Mad guna suti matreno mai sarbo guhasaye manogati ravichinna yatha gangam baso ambadhau lakshanam bhakti yogasya nirgunasya hi udarhitam ahitukya pratyata jayat जा भक्ति पुरुषोत्तमे। एक्चुअली आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड दैट Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur always speaking, bhakti is a natural function of your soul. Srila Jiva Goswami Pad has taken the example of this sloka by Kapil Bhagavan from Srimad Bhagavaji Mahapuran to refer the exact example of Sarupa Siddha Bhakti. What do you mean by Sarupa Siddha Bhakti? Sarupa Siddha Bhakti is always Nirguna Bhakti. Sarupa Siddha Bhakti is Nirguna Bhakti. So Sarupa Siddha Bhakti is always Nirguna Bhakti, no doubt. But due to contamination of heart, bhakti can be seen reflected in different forms. Actually, Kapil Bhagavan, Bhagavan Kapil, they're speaking to Mother Devahuti. Oh Mother, on hearing my glories, immediately when mind can get abnormal flowing power towards me sitting inside heart, like irresistible non-stop natural flow of Ganga towards ocean, at the same time which is causeless and above any side effect, and above any side effect of jnana, karma, etc., then this can become an exact example of Nirguna Bhakti or Sarupa Siddha Bhakti. So you should understand this point first. Bhakti, only for bhakti, nothing else. When we can do bhakti only to get bhakti, no reason is there, nothing else, in that case it is called pure bhakti. It is called Nirguna Bhakti, one-pointed bhakti. All our relationship and love in this material world is always full of self-interest. All our relationship and love in this material world is always full of self-interest and contradiction. Although sometimes can exhibit extreme excellency, but still a smell of interest must be there. Because this is material planet from where contamination, because this is material platform where contamination is a must. Sometimes we can see on material platform, we can see that this love can exhibit extreme excellency on this material platform. But still, a smell of interest must be there, because this is material platform where contamination is a must. You cannot avoid contamination, hesitation. The love affair of Nal and Damayanti, the love affair of Nal and Damayanti, or the love affair of Laila Majnu, or even the love affair of Jim and Della, cannot attain 100% perfection. It is not possible. Cannot attain 100% perfection, I mean purity. But any love affair which is seen on Vaikuntha platform is always 100% pure, no doubt. Vaikuntha platform means no trace of kuntha or hesitation can be there. Vaikuntha platform means no kind of hesitation, impediments, no trace of kuntha or hesitation can be there. Like the love of Hanumanji Maharaj for Sri Ramchandra, or the love of Bharatji Maharaj for Sri Ramchandra, etc. Though countless varieties of devotional love, though countless varieties of devotional love for Prabhu, Supreme Lord, Hari, can be seen, still each and every type of love and devotion must have some speciality. Through So you see, so though Sri Bhagavan is always saturated and satisfied, though we know that Sri Bhagavan is always saturated and satisfied due to his Atmaram Aptokam positional stand. He is always Aptokam and Atmaram. Still, this is the inconceivable, magical spell of Sarup Shakti Bhakti, that Bhagavan also became mad to get the taste of countless new devotional mode, countless way of countless devotees. This is the excellent excellency of devotional love affair of Bhagavan with his devotees. Brihat Bhagavatamrita, written by Srila Sanatan Goswami Pad, can give us clear conception on this topic or on this point. According to rasagata variety, according to the type of rasa, I mean according to rasagata variety, bhakti can always take different shape and design according to patra. Mainly five different kinds of bhakti rasa are available, like santa, dasa, sakshya, vatsalya, madhur. Also, madhur rasa has some speciality. There is some speciality also, sakriya, parakriya, etc. And also seven different types of gauna rasa. That is, previously I speak about mukha rasa. Now, gauna rasa also, seven different kinds of gauna rasa are there. Bivasa, birhasa, etc. Time to time, those rasa can appear or disappear according to the situation and circumstances. But aprakita rasa can be personified on Vaikuntha platform. Always remember, aprakita rasa can be personified on Vaikuntha platform. But material rasa, always unstable, and at the same time can become the cause of tight bondage for Jivatma. As per Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, this material world is the perverted reflection of the transcendental world. Also from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, compiled by Sri Rupa Goswami Pad, we can get the following Siddhanta, very accurate Siddhanta. Siddhanta tattaha tattaha bhede yopi siisha kishna sarupayo raseno utkrishyate krishna rupa mesha rasasthiti. Siddhanta tattva bheda yopi sri isha krishna sarupayo raseno krishyate krishna rupam isha rasasthiti. Perhaps you have gone through this sloka many times in my Harikatha. Actually, according to sarupa tattva vichar, Narayana and Krishna non-different from each other. But still, Rasagata excellency is more and more expressed with Krishna Tattva. We must confess this point. Because Krishna is Leela Purushottama, so always Rasagata excellency is present there. Krishna is the ocean of countless rasa. Krishna is the ocean, infinity ocean of rasa. Mahaprabhu, while giving introduction, while giving instruction to Rupa Goswami Pad speaking, "Hey Rupa, I cannot explain properly. It is not possible for me. Just I like to speak that Krishna is the ocean of mercy. Krishna is the ocean, infinity ocean of rasa. Just to give you a test, I am giving you one drop. I like to give one drop on your tongue so that you can get the test mellow and get inspiration to run for this rasa." Actually, similarly, Sri Ramchandra and Sri Krishna Chandra, non-different from each other. We know it very well. Tathagata Vichar, according to Tathagata Vichar, there is no difference. But still, Sri Ramchandra is Maryada Purushottama, whereas Sri Krishna is Leela Purushottama. With Sri Ramachandra, we can get maximum 2.5 rasa in applied form. It's called Arai Rasa, 2.5. With Sri Ramchandra, we can get maximum 2.5 rasa in applied form. Whereas all rasa, all possible rasa, we can get in applied form with Sri Krishna, Nanda Nandan. In Santa Rasa, always remember, in Santa Rasa, relationship with Bhagavan cannot be discovered. In Santa Rasa, relationship with Bhagavan cannot be discovered. So at all any service can be done, that can be done passive way. Actually, from Dasa Rasa, we Gauriya are very interested about different kind of rasa, but actually from Dasa Rasa, Dasa Rasa platform, seva can be done. Also from Chaitanya Charitamrita, we can get a nice piece of advice, you know all. Aisarya Sithil Prame Nahi Morpito. ঐশ্বর্য শিথিল প্রেমে নাহি মোর বিধ ফ্রম চৈতন্য চরিতামৃত ইউ ক্যান ফাইন্ড শ্লোকা আই মিন ঐশ্বর্য বাবা ক্যানট হেল্প ডিভোট ঐশ্বর্য বাবা ক্যানট হেল্প ডেভেলপ সুইট অ্যান্ড ফ্রি রিলেশনশিপ উইথ ভগবান ফ্রম হার্ট ঐশ্বর্য বাবা ক্যানট হেল্প আস টু গ্রো সুইট অ্যান্ড ফ্রি রিলেশনশিপ with Bhagavan from heart. That is the main problem. Only and only those Brajavasis, they have that kind of natural, I mean spontaneous, causeless, loveful relationship with the Shyam Sundar, Nandanandan Krishna. That's why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Brajavasir Sahabiki Piti Krishna Pati, Krishnero Sahabiki Puti, ব্রজবাসী পুতি স্বাভাবিক মানে ন্যাচুরাল ব্রজবাসী দে আর ফিলিং ন্যাচুরাল অ্যাট্রাকশন ফর কৃষ্ণ অ্যান্ড কৃষ্ণ অলসো ফিলিং ন্যাচুরাল অ্যাট্রাকশন ফর দোজ ব্রজবাসী কৃষ্ণের স্বাভাবিক পুতি ব্রজবাসী পুতি ব্রজবাসী স্বাভাবিক পুতি কৃষ্ণ প্রতি ইউ ক্যান গো থ্রু দিস শ্লোকা ফ্রম চৈতন্য চরিতামৃত শ্রী রামচন্দ্র পরব্রহ্ম You know, C.C. Ramachandra Parabrahma took birth at Ayodhya Dham as the son of King Dasaratha in four different forms like Ram, Lakshman, Bharat, Shatrughna. Same Advaigan Tata, but in four different forms going to appear to teach us Seva, everything, in four different forms. Just like you can remember, we are going to pay pranam to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I mean Gauranga, just like we speak, Panchatatnatakam Krishnam Bhaktarupa Sarupakam Bhaktavataram Bhaktaksham Bhaktasaktikam. Similar way. So we are going to pay dandavat to total Ram Tattva, not Ramchandra alone, because Dama, Nama, Parikar, Vaishishta, Leela, Parikar, Vaishishta, everything, all total paraphernalia, all in total, Adhyayam Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva, so Ram Tattva is one and single, but there is diversity. Adhyayam Tattva. So just like Panchatatmatakam Krishnam Bhaktarupa Sarupakam Bhaktavataram Bhaktakam Namami Hathas. We paid Dandavat. This is the pranam mantra of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Eternally present Sri Ram Leela. You should remember, eternally present Ram Leela. Ram Leela is eternally present. At present, just now when I am speaking Harikatha just now, anywhere in this whole infinity Brahmanda, somewhere, Ramji Maharaj taking birth. Just now. So this way, all Leela is Nitya. How Leela is Nitya, nobody understands. So Mahaprabhu giving example to Sanatana Goswami, that this way Leela Nitya, all Leela, anywhere in this infinity Brahmanda, somewhere, Krishna Leela, just now, Krishna going to take birth, Ramchandra going to take birth, this, that. Just now, Ramchandra going to forest, Ram now exile. So this way, eternally present Sri Ram Leela was bound to appear in front of Maharshi Valmiki Muni. Eternally present Ram Leela was bound to appear in front of Valmiki Muni. At least 60,000 of years before Sri Ramchandra's appearance at Ayodhya on Ram Navami Day. In this respect, I like to touch one point. Sri Ramchandra took birth in Surya Vamsa. So God's son Suryadev Maharaj was very, very happy So happy Surdadev Maharaj dancing in ecstasy. Surjadev Bhagavan, noon time, 12 o'clock, when Ramchandra took place, he is, you know, looking at the lotus feet of Ramchandra. See, Surja Bhagavan don't like to go ahead. Surja must move, na? If Surja going to stand in one place, how possible? It's not possible. Surja, every fraction of second changing his position. But now, due to the appearance of Sri Ramchandra, see, Surjadev Bhagavan is just mad. He is dancing and forget that I should move forward. He is going to fix up his mind and the lotus feet of Sri Ramchandra. And Chandra Bhagavan crying, why is Surjadev not moving forward? How I can get the chance to look the lotus feet, towards the lotus feet of Ramchandra? So he is, you know, big problem. Then Ramchandra giving assurance to Chandra, oh Chandra, you are crying now. I can also give you opportunity. I can also. So this way, Sri Krishna Bhagavan appear at night, 12 o'clock night time. And Chandra getting the scope to fix up his mind unto the lotus feet of Sri Krishna Chandra. This is a very nice philosophy actually. But this eternally present Sri Ram Lila was bound to appear in front of Maharshi Valmiki Muni at least 60,000 years before of Sri Ram Chandra's appearance at Ayodhya Ram Navami Day due to his exclusive bhajan. Previously, when he got the advice from Sri Naraji Maharaj Guru that you will have to chant Ram Nam continuously, but due to so much bad activities, he was not in a position to utter Ram Nam. So sinful activities, always killing people, snatching their belongings, everything. So now, by the advice of Sri Naraji Maharaj Gurudev, he started speaking Ramna, but first he was not able to speak Ramna. He's speaking Mara, 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 Mani, Mara means dead body. Then Naraji Maharaj was fed up and speaking, okay, you go on speaking Mara, 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 Mara. Someday Ram can come in reverse form. Mara, 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 Mara. This way, like Mathura. Mathura is starting our mind. That's why Mathura. Mathura, Mathura, Mathura. Yes, this is a nice philosophy here. Also, we should remember that Tulsidas Ji Maharaj, while doing bhajan at Chitrakut Parvat, was able to see the eternal Sri Ram Lila directly, to compile Ramacharitamanasa in a very lucid way for common people by the order of Sri Kashi Vishwanath Mahadev. So you should remember also, Sri Tulsidas Ji Maharaj, while doing bhajan at Chitrakut Parvat, was able to see the eternal Sri Rama Lila directly, to compile Ramcharitamanasa in a very lucid form, lucid way for common people by the order of Kashi Vishwanath. All different kinds of avatars of the Supreme Lord Krishna has their respective speciality. All different kinds of avatars of the Supreme Lord Krishna has their respective speciality. What to speak more? See, Sri Sriman Mahaprabhu Sri Krishna Chaitanya was bound to give a special testimony. See, Sriman Mahaprabhu Sri Krishna Chaitanya was bound to give a special testimony to Murari Gupta, who is Hanuman avatar. Sriman Mahaprabhu Sri Krishna Chaitanya was bound to give a special testimony to see Murari Gupta about his overflowing strong love and devotion, dedication for Sri Ramchandra, his Ishtadev. Also, Sri Rupa Sanatan, both of them wanted to test the strong love of their younger brother Anupama for his Ishtadeva Ramchandra. Also, you can remember Sriman Mahaprabhu was very, very impressed. Sriman Mahaprabhu was very, very impressed to see the exclusive ragati of Rama Bhajanandi Vipra at South India. You can remember. Sriman Mahaprabhu that day was supposed to take Bhikta Pradam there at his Bhajan Kutir. But what happens? But it was late noon time, but still the Bipra was sitting, not cooking. Follow what I say. Sriman Mahaprabhu was supposed to take Bhiksha Prasadam there at the Bhajan Kutir of that Ram Bhajanandi Bipra. But it is surprising, but it was late noon time, but still Bipra was sitting, not cooking. Being asked by Sriman Mahaprabhu, being asked the reason for why he is not cooking, being asked by Sriman Mahaprabhu the reason for why he is not cooking, he replied to Sriman Mahaprabhu that, see, at present Ramchandra is in exile. So Lakshman has gone to forest to collect items of cooking, so Sita Devi can cook shortly after his arrival. Then Sriman Mahaprabhu could easily understand his exclusive bhajan mood. He was very happy, Mahaprabhu. One day, that Vipra, crying and speaking out of strong grief, I have heard that Rakshas Ravan has abducted Chasti Sita Lakshmi. That I have heard. So no more I like to live. I like to jump into fire. My Sita Thakurani abducted by Rakshas Ravan. Sriman Mahaprabhu was really very, very happy to see the exclusive bhakti mood of that Brahman devotee. But at the same time started giving consolation to him with this appropriate Siddhanta Vani that, see, Brahman, Parasakti of Ramachandra, Parasakti of Sri Ramachandra Sita is transcendental in nature. So how it is possible for Ravan to touch her body? Try to think over and again. What to speak about touching? Even he cannot see her. But still, the Brahman was very sorry. Later on, A supported document from Kurma Puran was collected by Saman Mahaprabhu from South India, Dakshin Bharat, collected from South India, related documents, supporting document, and that Brahman was given that Kurma Puran was collected, and it was given to that Vipra Brahman to stop his crying. Also, we know from Chaitanya Charitamrita that a Raga Bhakta who had his direct feeling like Dasaratha, also you can remember, also we know from Chaitanya Charitamrita that a Raga Bhakta who had his direct feeling like Dasaratha's unending strong love for Sri Ramchandra, was bound to leave his body as and when he heard that Sri Ram gone to exile, gone to forest for 14 years. Really, this is called direct realization. That devotee is Siddha devotee. So who had his direct feeling like Dasaratha's unending strong love for Sri Ramchandra. And he was bound to leave his body at once, when he heard that Sri Ram gone to exile for 14 years. He leave his body. That is called Siddhi. Really, this is called direct realization, without which rag bhajan is not possible. Truly speaking, false rag bhajan can put us in trouble forever. Slow but steady win the race. This formula we should follow. False rag bhajan can put us in trouble forever. All those Muni rishis at Dandakaranya forest wanted to embrace Sri Ramachandra with exclusive mood of Madhur Rasa. But Maryada Purushottama Sri Ramachandra, couldn't allow it. All those Muni rishis at Dandakaranya forest wanted to embrace Sri Ramachandra with excellent mood of Madhur Rasa. But Maryada Purushottama Sri Ramachandra could not accept them that way. But told them with full assurance, to fulfill their desire in Dwapar Yuga in the form of Nandanandan Krishna Leela Purushottama. So those Muni rishis, they all took birth at Vrindavan Dham with Gopi Baba to serve Sri Supreme Lord Nandanandan Krishna. To serve Supreme Lord in Parakya Madhur Rasa Bhava, Sri Ramchandra give them full assurance that they can come out successful, but not now. They will have to wait for Dwapar Yuga to come. Sri Rama Avatara is the most exclusive avatara to establish truthfulness, everything. Sri Rama Avatara is the most exclusive avatara to establish truthfulness, purity, idealism, impartialism, neutral mood, morality, heroism, fearlessness, firmness, tenderness, and especially submissive attitude was expressed by him in front of Rishi, Muni, Guru, Vaishnav, and all elderly personalities. This was his specialty. One day, see, Ramchandra was there with Gurudev, Vishwamitra Muni. In a forest near, you know, near some place, I mean, the name of the place is the Sita Devi Zavirbhav place, Sita Mori. It is one name of the place, Sita Mori. It is actually Mithila. Near Mithila, there was a small forest. So that time, one day, Gurudev speaking, "Ho Ram." "Yes, Gurudev. Actually, I have information that Dasarathji Maharaj has come in Mithila. You like to meet him? You are interested to meet him?" Ramchandra, shrugging his head, down his head, and speaking very polite way, "Guruji, as you like." "You like to meet him?" "Gurudev, as you like." This kind of softness, tenderness, submission is not possible in any avatar. Exclusive. His noble idealism or character is really the topmost and remarkable milestone for us all forever. We should remember this point. So Krishna Lila is so secret that common people cannot understand, sometimes misunderstand. In that case, they can get the help from Sri Rama Lila and his teachings to get Kripa very easily. Sri Ramchandra, together with Sita and Lakshman actually, Sri Ramchandra, while in exile, was bound to undergo exclusive austerity and penances, which was unbearable to Sita Devi and Lakshman. Whole world speaking all rubbish against Kaikeyi Mata. You can remember, whole world speaking all rubbish against Kaikeyi Mata. You know, three wives of Dasaratha: Kausalya, Kaikeyi, Sumitra. So Kaikeyi, everybody hate. Nobody going to keep. Nobody going to keep the name of their daughter in the name of Kaikeyi. They hate Kaikeyi. Why? Whole world speaking all rubbish against Kaikeyi Mata for sending Sri Ramchandra in exile for 14 years. But they don't know that the exclusive love and dedication of Kaikeyi Mata, they don't know. They don't know the exclusive love and dedication of Kaikeyi Mata. Though we know that Sri Ram took birth at the lap of Kausalya Mataji, we know, though we know that Sri Ramchandra took birth at the lap of Kausalya Mataji, but still we should remember the exclusive love and care of Kaikeyi for Sri Ramchandra all along. I mean, right from the beginning, I mean, right from the birth, not even a single fraction of second, we can discover in the life of Kaikeyi Mata, not even a single fraction of second we can discover in the life of Kaikeyi Mata when we can point out that she was busy with her self-interest. Her every breath, in every inhalation, exhalation, I mean, her every breath, speaking Ram, 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 Ram. So what? Why people going to speak all rubbish? They don't know the actual Siddhanta. Especially, she is the mother of Bharat, the great. We should remember how possible that Kaikeyi is a rubbish. Especially, she is the mother of Bharat, the great. Then how it was possible for her to send Sri Ram Chandra? Then how it was possible for her to send Sri Ram Chandra, the heart? Then how it was possible for her to send Sri Ram Chandra, the heart, to exile for 14 years? Really strange. That is the main question. We should always remember that all typical seva, I mean task, Bhagavan, I mean Prabhu, always like to be done by his personal associates. You should remember this. We should remember that all typical tasks, Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, Prabhu, always like to be done by his personal associates. Shankar Bhagavan, the great, was given the responsibility to preach Mayavada, whereas he is full of bhakti, Vaishnavanam Yathasambhu. But Shankara, the great, was given the responsibility to preach Mayavada Vasya. Also, drink kalkut poison, etc. He was given responsibility. Why? Because topmost intimacy is there with Shankar. Vaishnavanam yathasam. Nimnaganam yatha ganga devanam achyuto yatha Vaishnavanam yathasambhu purananam tiram bhagavatam. Similarly, by the exclusive request and desire of Sri Ram Chandra, Sri, I mean Kaikeyi, was bound to send Sri Ram Chandra to exile. Really so? Yes. Similarly, by the exclusive request and desire of Sri Ram Chandra, Sri, I mean Kaikeyi, was bound to send him, I mean Sri Ram Chandra, to exile. Also, if Sri Ramchandra not going to exile, then how it can be possible for us to get all those exclusive sweet lila? It is not possible. So it is one kind of, you know, very nice Siddhanta. How we can get all different kind of lila, nice sweet lilas, if Ramchandra at all not going to exile? See, Ramchandra, so it was a must to send him to exile. It is the exclusive desire of Ramchandra Prabhu himself. See, Ramchandra, being Supreme Lord, always remember, see, Ramchandra being Supreme Lord, nothing impossible for him. He need not take the help of monkey Tim to fight with Ravana. You should remember, he need not take the help of monkey Tim to fight with Ravana. But still, to express the sweetness of human lila, he was bound to do that way. He was crying for Sita Devi, running forest to forest in search of Sita. Sita, 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 where you are? Just like an ordinary human being. To bestow kripa on bestow kripa on Hanumanji Maharaj, Moni Rishis, to bestow kripa on Moni Rishis, to bestow kripa on Vibhishan. So it was really necessary. This way Ramchandra doing all Leela like human, ordinary human being. See, Ramchandra, Supreme Lord, was doing Leela like human being. All Leela is doing. Really, Sita was abducted by Ravana? Really Sita was abducted by Ravana? No, not at all. Not at all. Sita was not abducted by Ravana. Sita was not at all Sati. Sita was not at all abducted by Ravana. Sriman Mahaprabhu already has clarified this point. I already told you. Mahaprabhu was speaking in front of that Ram Bhajanandi Vipra. When Ravana came in the form of Sannyasi Vesha to beg from Sita Devi with a pre-plan to abduct her, then Sita Devi was bound to give a nice chance scope of seva to Agni Deva to cover her chit body, a pragida body, with light and flame, so that Ravan cannot touch her. At the same time, Agni Dev was bound to forward a shadow figure, Maya Sita, in front of Ravan. And Ravan was able to abduct that Maya Sita. Those all are the secrecy of Sri Ram Leela, Aprakita Ram Leela. Still, after getting victory over Ravana and killing Ravana, after getting victory over Lanka, killing Ravana, when Ramchandra came back to Ayodhya, then to verify the purity, Chasti Baba of Sita Mata Thakurani, to verify the purity, Chasti Baba of Sita, he was bound to arrange Agni Pariksha Agni Pariksha, two times. During second fire testing, Agni Pariksha, during second fire testing, Agni Pariksha, Sita Devi wanted to go back to the eternal abode from this Bhauma, Ayodhya. So, did not came back again. Sri Ramchandra started crying like an ordinary human being. Earth, Prithibi Ma cracked down and Sita Devi gone under. You know, the whole. Especially because of some doubts expressed by some people residing in his country, I mean kingdom. Especially because of some doubts expressed by some people residing in his kingdom, he was bound to put Sita Devi in testing. Sri Ramchandra personally never expressed any doubt about her, because Sita Devi is his Sarupa Shakti, non-different from himself. It is the main symptom of demon or Rakshasa. It is the main symptom of a demon or Rakshasa that they always like to abduct the Shakti of Bhagavan. They always like to abduct the Shakti of Bhagavan. They are all number one Mayavadis. They are all number one Mayavadis. Ravan wanted to abduct Sita Devi, it's true. Shakuni Nandan, Brikasur, wanted to abduct Gauri. Mahishasur wanted to abduct Durga. Shishupal Pasupal wanted to take away Rukmini Devi, etc. How it is possible to abduct Sarup Shakti, which is non-different from Supreme Lord? Foolish, number one. But they are so foolish that they cannot understand this simple point that Shakti cannot be separated from Shaktiman, Supreme Lord. From Vedanta Sutra, we have documents, we know that Shakti, Shakti Matur Abhet. Those foolish Mayavadis, they think that if we are going to accept any other tattva rather than Adaigan tattva, I mean Shakti tattva we are going to confess, then our basic Advaita Bad Siddhanta cannot stand. They cannot understand that Shakti and Shaktiman both are non-different from each other. That is the main problem. They are all Mayavadi. It is a vital duty of a genuine devotee to protest strongly against those demonic people, those who want to abduct Shakti of abduct the Shakti of Supreme Lord. The devotee must protest, must strike. Even Jatayu, the great bird, even Jatayu, the great bird, was bound to fight with Ravana while Sita Devi was being abducted by him. We can remember. Ultimately, Jatayu fell down on ground waiting to give this information to Sri Ramchandra before death. So he was waiting before death, living body. Ultimately, he was successful to meet Ramchandra, who is searching Sita Devi in different forest. At the last moment when Sri Ramchandra was informed by Jatayu, just before leaving body, all the topics about this incident, how Sita Devi abducted by Ravan, then the endless ocean, of merciful incarnation Sri Ramchandra took up the body on his own lap to do Abhishek of Jatayu, the friend of Father Dasaratha Maharaj, with tears of ears, best Abhishek, the best Abhishek was done by Sri Ramchandra, funeral, you know, duties. Baladeva Sankarsan was bound to appear as the younger brother of Sri Ramchandra Lakshman. So all along Sri Lakshman was very, very sorry to watch all the sufferings of Sri Ramchandra, his astridian penances, the elder brother, I mean Sri Ramchandra, but still could not speak anything. A single word against him, because he is junior, younger brother. He was suffering very much to see the astrity and penances of Parathara Hiresha Sri Ramchandra. It was unbearable, but still, Lakshman was bound to keep silence because he is younger. Only to serve Prabhu Sri Ramchandra silently, because this was the motto of his life, I mean Lakshmanji. To carry out the order of Prabhu Sri Ramchandra, he was always alert, night, day, all the time, round the clock. But he took resolution to take birth next as the elder brother of Prabhu, to get control over his fanciful attitude and to get control over his sufferings. So Sri Baladev Ji Maharaj was able to serve Sri Krishna more exclusive way. So you can remember the excellency of Sri Ram Lila. Also, I would like to touch one or two points more. There's very vital Siddhanta. Some foolish people speaking Ramchandra going to South India before crossing the ocean. He was bound to worship Mahadev, Rameswaram. So they are expressing this kind of wrong Siddhanta. They are speaking Ramasa Ishwarai Ti Rameswaraha. But they don't know the excellency. They don't know the mood of Sri Ramchandra. They don't know the mood of Sri Shankar Bhagavan. Ram Jasa Ishwaraha Iti Rameswaraha. Ram Jasya Iswaraha Iti Rameswara Mahadev. This Siddhanta is appropriate. The kind of love and affection shown by Sri Ramchandra for everybody, each and everybody, those who are in a position to help Ramchandas some or other way. Even one squirrel, Katbirali it is called. In Hindi we speak Gilari, squirrel, was trying to help, in the seva of bridge making, Rameswaram Setu. Going to water to take bath, again coming to sand, and all sand is taking, you know, on body and throwing into ocean to show that I am also trying to help our Prabhu. I like to also, I also like to do seva. This kind of exclusive seva. When Ramchandra looking at the squirrel is very, very happy. Taking the squirrel hand, you know, he is, you know, giving some loveful touch of fingers. So you can find three line on the backside of all each and every squirrel. It's a loveful, you know. Hanumanji Maharaj, he was the main supporter all the time, helping Sri Ramchandra. Sometimes keep taking Ramchandra on soldier, Ram and Lakshan, and flying from here and there, jumping. This way, Hanumanji Maharaj helping Jambuvan, who is the avatar of Brahmaji, also helping. These were all different way everybody wanted to help, cooperate Ramchandra, wanted to help, serve Ramchandra. How exclusive way Hanumanji Maharaj first jump and cross the ocean and reach Lanka to enter into Asoka Van, Asoka village, Asoka forest. They are all the troops of Ravana. They are all Asura and Rakshasa. They are keeping close watch on Sita Devi in the forest. Sita Devi crying all day and night. Then Hanumanji Maharaj reaching in front of Sarupa Sakti of Ramchandra, Sita Devi in the form of a fly, and speaking to Sita Devi, I'm your son, I'm coming. Ramchandra giving his ring so that you can identify that I am the messenger of Ram. So no problem. Very shortly, Sri Ramchandra, my Prabhu, and we all trying our best to rescue you. Oh Mother, you bless me. This way actually Hanumanji Maharaj doing all exclusive seva. Every exclusive seva. I'm bound to speak this way actually. One day Sita Devi was very, very happy to give Hanumanji Maharaj one very nice, you know, of very precious pearl. Hanumanji Maharaj taking the pearl, which is very, very fine and costly, and going to cut with teeth. And laughing. Sita Devi speaking, why you are cutting? I am giving you so costly thing. Hanumanji Maharaj speaking, Ma, I am watching whether Ram, my Prabhu, is there in each and every, you know, pearl of the garland. If I cannot see my Prabhu, what use? What use? This kind of exclusive love and affection and seva. Dedication shown by Hanumanji Maharaj. Hanumanji Maharaj was caught by Sri Ravana and he was taken in front of Ravana. Ravana asking, who you are? Hanumanji Maharaj thinking, what kind of identity I can give in front of this Rakshasa? He cannot understand. Then Sita Devi in fine form coming in here and speaking, why not you speak? Why not to speak that you are the servant of Sri Ram? Yes, yes, yes. I must speak. I am the servant of Sri Ram Chandra. Hanumanji Maharaj speaking. But Sri Ravana Rakshasa popped up. He's laughing. Ha, ha, You are servant. When I see your power, I thought that you are, maybe you are a great king of a great country. But you are servant? Hanuman was speaking, yes, I am servant. But the servant of Parak Parakleshwar Bhagavan Sri Ramchandra. You are the servant of Mayadevi. Try to understand this point. Ravana expressing false ego very much, ultimately took decision to catch that monkey and set fire on his leg. Hanumanji Maharaj, very glad, let him do it. After that, I can do nice seva of Ramchandra. Then actually Ravan arranged to set fire on the tail of Hanumanji Maharaj. And Ravan thought he is going to die now. Who can save him? Hanuman Maharaj going to jump from one building to another building. This a whole Lanka, golden Lanka, golden Lanka, whole Lanka was burnt up by the fire set by Sri Hanumanji Maharaj from his tail. Whole Lanka was burned up. Thousands of people there going to die. Ultimately, Hanumanji Maharaj wanted to put off the flame, so wanted to put the fire on his own mouth. So ultimately, some impact we can see on the mouth of, on the face of Sri Hanumanji Maharaj, because Hanumanji Maharaj, his face was very nice red in color. But ultimately, when fire touching the face, whole face, it burnt up, it's black. From them onward, all the monkey, amen, they are going to show black face by the mercy of Sita Devi. So this way, Hanumanji Maharaj doing exclusive seva, and you know already, when Shakti Sail was applied by the son of Sivavana, then Lakshmanji Maharaj was expressing some leela as if he is out of order, as if he is, you know, gone out of order, he is, you know, fell unconscious. Then Hanumanji was giving responsibility to go and find Vishala Karani. Hanumanji was jumping and going to Himalaya to search Vishala Karani, but could not trace out. The time was very short. Within that short period, there was big problem in between. So I'd like to speak because time is very limited. Then with the hill itself, Hanumanji Bar take the hill on one Gandhamadan Parvat, taking in left hand and jump and cross the ocean, come here to show the hill so that this the doctor, Ayurvedic doctor, can search out the Vishala Karani leaf. That way, Hanumanji Maharaj was bound to take Vishala Karani in front of doctor, Ayurvedic doctor. So Lakshmanji Maharaj got back his consciousness. All these people, material people, explaining wrong way. They don't know the excellency of this leela. Actually, Brahma giving kripa to the son of Ravana. So, for a short period, he was bound to make the speech, the benediction of Brahma successful. Brahma giving benediction. So, Lakshmanji Maharaj, Parat Parakhileshwar, he was bound to make it success. Otherwise, you know, from 7th canto Bhagavatam, we know, Satyam vidhatum nija vitta vasitam. What my servant speaking, it cannot be lie. So to prove it, for some time, Lakshmanji Maharaj, with Balaji Maharaj himself, Sankarsa says, Almighty, infinity power, was bound to show that kind of leela. But foolish people, they don't understand. All important, you know, poet, you know, like Madhusudan Datta, the idiot. He was bound to write this leela in such a way, Meghnad Bodh Kabba, in such a way, so that you can discover when you go to this poem, you can find Lakshman is a very, you know, weak person, ordinary man. So Meghnad is very powerful. This is the brain, rotten brain of those foolish people. They never like to take the help of Guru Vaishnava to understand this leela. They like to make meaning of this leela themselves. That's why totally from beginning to end, they are failure to understand the gravity of this Bhagavat leela. They cannot understand of this leela. So ultimately, by Pushpakrat, all troops and Sita Devi, with Sita Devi, Ramji Maharaj, together with Lakshman, they all flying and Pushparat, they are flying from Lanka, coming to Ayodhya, and all demigods, they are showering flowers from Nandankanan in a big way to give greetings and prayer. They are speaking all prayer in front of their Prabhu Sri Ramchandra. Om Namo Bhagavate Paramahansa Rasasadito. Om Namo Bhagavate Paramahansa Rasasadito. Chinmakarandayo Bhakta Janamana Sanivasayo Siram Chandraya Namo Namaha. Apadam Apahartaram Dataram Sarvasampadam Ramabhiramam Bhuyo Bhuyo Namamiham. Om Namo Bhagavate Paramahansa Rasasadito Charana Kamalo Chinmakarandayo Bhakta Janamanasa Nivasayo Sri Ram Chandrayo Namo Namah. Jai Ram Sri Ram Jai Jai Ram 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 Sri Ram Chandra ki palu bhajamana haran baba bhaya darunam. Sri Ram Chandra ki palu bhajamana haran baba bhaya darunam. Nava kanja lochan kanja mukha kara Kanja pada kanjarunam Kandarpa yaganita yamita chabinava Niloni radha sundaram Patapito manu hutarita ruchi suchi Naumi janaka sutavaram Bhajudina bandhu dinesho dhanava Daito Bangsha Nikandanam Raghunanda Yananda Kanda Kausala Chandra Dasaratha Nandanam Sira Mukuta Kundala Tilaka Charu Udaru Anga Vibhushanam Ajanu Bhuja Sara Chapadara Sangramo jita kara dushanam iti badati tulasi dasa sankara muni mana ranjanam iti badati tulasi dasa sankara seso muni mana ranjanam mama hridaya kanja nivasa guru श्रीरामचन्द्र कृपालु हर नव भय दारु नव कञ्ज लोचन कञ्ज मुख कर कञ्ज पद कञ्ज कान्धार भय गणित नील नीर अत पीत मानु करित रुचि सुचि नौमी जनक सुधावर मजु दीन बंधु दिनेश दान दैत्य वंश निकंदन रघुनंद आनंद कंद कुशल चंद दशरथ नंदन शिर मुकुट कुंडल तिलक चारु उदार अंग विभूषण आजान भुज सर चापर ग्राम जित कर दूषण इति वदति तुलसीदास शंकर शेष मुनि मनोरंजन मम हृदय पंज निवास कुरु कामादि खल दल जय राम श्री राम जय जय राम 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 मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तम श्री रामचंद्र इज लीला एंड टीचिंग्स ओके एंड दंडवात वाचकल्पतरु अस्य कृपासिन्धु व्यवच्छ पतितानं पावनेभ्यो अवैष्णवेभ्यो नमः।